Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to the science class. We are doing chapter 11, reproduction in plants. We have studied about sexual reproduction in plants, how it takes place with the help of seeds. The processes involved were pollination and fertilization. As a result of fertilization, fruit formation and seed formation takes place. Now, what would happen if these seeds would fall and germinate near the parent plant only? All same type of plants will be growing in the same area, in a small limited area. What would happen? The plants will not get enough sunlight, minerals, water, space, etc. So there will be a competition for all these resources. For this purpose, it is necessary that the seeds which have been produced by the parent plant should reach suitable, favorable places so that they can grow there without any competition. This occurs by a process called seed dispersal. Seed dispersal is a process by which seeds get scattered far away from the mother plant. Now, there are various means by which the seeds get scattered away. You must have observed also. But basically there are four methods which we are going to discuss in this class. Seed dispersal by wind, seed dispersal by water, seed dispersal with the help of animals, and seed dispersal with the help of explosion. Let us discuss one by one. Seed dispersal with the help of wind. Now for this purpose the seeds should be light in weight, so that they can be easily carried away. Such seeds, they have some wing-like structure. This is the seed of dandelion. In this, you can see this wing-like structure. This is very lightweight seed, and as soon as the wind blows, the seeds get carried away with the wind to far off places where they can settle and germinate. You must have seen some cotton-like structures flying in the air with a small dark spot in them. That is also seed. Okay. So that seed is also being scattered by wind. Like in calotropis also it happens that fruit opens up and the seeds which are having white hair-like structures all around them, they get scattered away. Then maple seeds, they have wing-like structures like this, so that they can fly away easily. Another common example is of drumstick. Drumstick is a tree in which you have long stick-like fruit, and from that the seed comes out, and it is also having wing-like structure and which can be easily carried away by the wind. So this is how seed dispersal happens with the help of wind. Then second is seed dispersal with the help of water. For this purpose, the seed should be spongy so that it can float on water. Most common example for seed dispersal by water is coconut. Coconut, although it's quite heavy, but it is having that spongy hair-like structures in the outer layer, which makes it easily float on the water. So coconuts, when they fall in water, they get carried away by the water current to another bank where they can easily germinate. Third is with the help of animals. Animals scatter seeds in different ways. Some of the animals, they eat the fruits, throw away the seeds, like monkeys. Even human beings, we purchase fruits, we throw away the seeds in different places. So that is also one way of scattering the seeds. Now, another, birds, they eat the fruit, unable to digest the seeds. They are excreting the seeds in various places so that seeds also can germinate. Next is the seeds which are having spiny structure. Means small spines like structures are there, which when they come in contact with the hair of animals or even clothes of human beings, they get stuck to it. One very common example is cockle bur. Cockle bur is having this kind of spiny structure, and you must have seen this cockle bur. The dried seeds this stick to the tail of cows, then body of dogs and all, and when they brush, they just rub themselves. These seeds fall off, and they might germinate in that other place. So this is how animals scatter the seeds. And lastly, it is explosion. Scattering by explosion means the fruit, when it dries up, it suddenly opens up, releasing the seeds. So these seeds, they are thrown away from the fruit. So this is how the seed dispersal by explosion happens. It is very common in sweet pea, beans, then poppy seeds are also scattered by this way, then balsam. Most of these seeds are having this kind of fruit, so that when there is a slit-like structure, when they dry up, it opens up on its own. So children, this is how the scattering of seeds takes place. Let us have a revision. Seeds, they need to germinate in favorable places where there is no competition for nutrients, sunlight, water, etc. So they get scattered away, and the process by which the seeds scatter away from the parent plant is known as seed dispersal. And seed dispersal mainly happens by four matters: wind, water, animals, and explosion. So with this, we come to an end of this chapter. Children, I hope this video will help you to understand the concept. Do watch the video and go through the book. And in case